Oh boy, he's hurting me pretty bad. Oh geez. Wow, I don't have the health for this. I thought I did. Ow. Howdy folks, and welcome back to Ark Adventures Anunnaki Genesis on the Centered Map. And before we get started, I was just looking at my face here and thinking it would be kind of cool to put a little war paint on. And I seem to recall somewhere that they talked about a way to paint yourself, because I know you can paint other people by using a paintbrush, but I think somebody said something about, or I read somewhere, something about being able to paint yourself, and I think it has to do with, do you just drag this over the, yeah, that's how you do it. You drag it over yourself. Okay, let's put a little war paint on then, huh? Let's take off this chest piece. Let's take off the headpiece. There you go, that's good, because it's just my face that I want to paint here. What kind of paint do we want? Red, yeah, but let's use a different kind of red. Let's use dark red. Is there alpha red in here? I think I have alpha red, don't I? Red. I thought I had alpha red. I think I have alpha red. Let's see, alpha. Scroll to the top. That's alpha dark red. Okay. Alpha light red. Alpha black. Because we're in alpha, you know. let's try the dark red first. Let's see what we can do. Put this here. By the way, I didn't say my normal introduction. What we're going to do for today is we're actually going to see about fighting a warden. See if we can actually do it. I'm willing to take the chance. Okay, now, if I remember correctly from my old-fashioned painting here, you hold down shift and left mouse button to thick paint. So if I want a thick paint, what color am I using? I'm using this paintbrush. Why am I not painting? Why is it not painting? Not painting. Left to paint. I'm using dark red. Okay. Let's use this one. No paint there. What am I doing wrong, guys? What am I doing wrong? I've got my paintbrush. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I'm left clicking and dragging. That's not doing any good. Shift, not doing any good. Dang it. Hi, Astrid. I wanted to do some war paint. Why can't I do any war paint? Man, can't even put lipstick on. Oh, well. We'll have to try that again later. Look it up. Maybe it's something that's broken now or something of that nature. So, actually, just add all items that are compatible. Since this is the paint shelf, it'll just put the paint and the paintbrushes. So what we wanted to do was I wanted to confirm how tough all of my guys are for fighting of the wardens. And by the way, you used to be able to turn the mega just by turning your mouse. You can't do that anymore. You used to be able to, but you can't now. It just kind of sucks. But you can move sideways. So if I regular attack and constantly regular attack with the mega, it's 95,924. So we're getting 95,000 DPS. And of course, the spin is the same damage. It just takes a little bit more energy, takes longer to do, but has a much wider area of effect. So he's not, I don't think, our best. Let's move him up. And I know that these guys over here are less. All of these alphas and all of that stuff are... I haven't tried the Dodo Rex. Let's try the Dodo Rex. This is not a high-level Dodo Rex, right? See it max? He's max level and he's only 5-something. So he's not max level at all. He's got really good damage from his fire. He can attack fairly quickly. This DPS will be low because I paused after the first attack. So we'll keep going. I can get 99. It's not bad. All right. Let's let that clear. Let's let that DPS clear. Now let's use the fire. Each fire is pretty damaging. But it takes more than a second to do. So we're getting 121 DPS. 121,000 DPS. And it uses up stamina pretty well. Okay. DPS is what we care about here. Because it's not going to be a one-shot kill thing. Ouch. So the next thing we want to try is Scotty, who is our toughest wyvern. Scotty, there we go. Now his regular bite is not that impressive. Oh, actually it is, 145, 686. And if we just mash that, we're doing better than the DPS on the Dodorex. So that's so far our best DPS. The flames, same thing, but we can't do it as frequently. But he does do, yeah, 116. So it looks like our best bet is going to be to fly Scotty, which is what I thought would be the case. And try to get his bites, if we can get bites in. Use flame if we have to, if we have to stay off a little bit. And I think we want to take, you know, guys, I don't know if this will work. So I kind of want to hold Hamish back, Hamish and Trisha back. So I think I'm going to take Scotty and Bud and Lou. And I'm going to have Bud and Lou attack what I attack. I look like really bright red in there. Oh, it's the Dodorex. Take Scotty and have Bud and Lou attack with me. And if I lose Scotty and I lose Bud and Lou, it won't be the end of the world. Because I'll have Hamish still, and I'll have Trisha, and we can make some more. And I can always go find some more as well. So, all right. Well, next step we have to do then is prepare for the battle. And to prepare for the battle, you know, I'm going to do a couple of things. One, I'm going to get rid of a lot of my stuff. Actually, I should probably keep that, the grapples, because otherwise I might not be able to get back onto them. Let's go ahead and get rid of all of this stuff. I'll leave that. I'll get rid of that. I'll get rid of my armor. Because if I die during this process, I don't want to have to, you know, get all that stuff back. So, how are we looking? Kind of naked. Wearing a bikini. Going to the beach. I'll take a little bit more meat because I might need some. In fact, I'll take all of that meat. Meat's cheap. All right. Well, I think we're ready to go. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab Scotty and we're going to have Bud and Lou follow, and we're going to go try to find a warden. See if we can kill one. I know that they're all kind of tough, so I'll have to see which one's the... We'll do a little research, try to figure out which one's the easiest one to attack. But we may only find one, so we might have no choice. And we'll just see what happens, guys. You know? You only live once, right? YOLO! Well, folks, we didn't have to travel far from base to find this guy. He is a Karkinos, a warden of the... And this stupid bug again. Warden of the rivers. I don't know how tough he is or isn't. I couldn't find any good resource on that quickly. I know it's out there. I just didn't search for very long. So we're going to just whistle attack. I guess I'm going to come in with my... I did it. We're going to come back out this way. Hopefully he doesn't go into the water. I did my whistle, but they're not doing anything for some reason. I really wish he'd come off out of the water, because I hear that they get like buffs in the water. The water ones do. Let's try that again. There we go. They're going for the attack. We're going to try attacking as well. Gotta watch our health. Our health is dropping fast, man. Alright, I gotta get the heck out of here. Get. Alright, fuck. He's a health booster. And a stamina booster. Oh boy. I'm not sure I'm attacking. I'm gonna die. Scotty's dead. And my other guys are dead too. There's no way. Yep, there's no way. There's no way. I'm dead. Wow. I don't think I'm ready. I don't think I'm ready. I'm not ready. Scotty's gone. Scotty's gone. Let me move. The battle's raging over there. There's Scotty's dead body. Oh, let's go take Hamish. I'm not going to fight with Hamish, I don't think, unless my guys are getting close to killing the thing. Come on, Hamish. Oh, no, they just flew up. Did I lose one of my other dudes as well? I think I did. Okay, Lou is down here. Where's Bud? Bud must have passed as well. This must be Bud. Okay. Oh, that's gonna hurt. What? What is screaming at me? Hamish, what are you doing, dude? Oh, that's what's fighting. Oi. Okay. Okay. Which one are you? You were Bud. Sorry, Bud. I'm really sorry, man. I need to get you down here. Follow, and you go past her for a moment, please. Where's my stuff? Where's my bag? Did I have a bag drop? I think I did. We're gonna have to draw that guy out in order to get my stuff, though. Can I draw him? Can he follow me? Will he follow me? Oh, man. I'm not gonna be able to go back to get my other wyvern saddle and all of those health potions and stuff. I don't think. See if he'll come over here. He likes the water. He's kind of coming this way. I'm probably going to find out by doing a little bit more research that he's like the toughest one to fight or something. Come on. Come on, come this way. Get away from there. I'm going to try to look for my stuff. Okay, fine. We'll just head back over here. I'll bring whichever one survived. Which one are you, Bud or Lou? I don't remember. I lost part of the duo. No. I knew I probably would. All right, so you can stop following me, sir. That's Lou. Lou Costello. The funny man is still here. The straight man. We lost the straight man. Poor Bud. Okay. So, what I'm going to do next is try to get over there. Let me offload this wyvern saddle. We'll put it over here. And I'm going to see if I can somehow get my body back using a corpse finder to know exactly where it was and kind of sneak in there, maybe without the warden seeing. We'll see how it goes. Okay, I've flown the Batman out here, and the corpse finder has shown two corpses. One is me and one is the bird. I don't know which one is which. Of course, there's those guys out here. Which is not going to be fun. I flew the Batman because, you know, he's cute and everything, but if I ended up losing him, I wouldn't be sad. And he can fly. I needed a flyer. So, piranha. I almost want to come back now. Yeah, you know what? Now that I know where that one is, I'm going to come back with something that can actually breathe some fire and kill all those piranha so that I can get my stuff. Let's come back and let's grab Hamish. And land Hamish. In fact, is it Hamish I want, or do I want to land? Let's grab Payne, because I really don't want to lose Hamish right now. Actually, let's just take Lou. Come on, Lou. Cut. Come on. I gotta do something about the collisions on these things. We'll take Lou. And hit zero again on my corpse finder. There we go. There's my corpses. The two that I had. Let's go ahead and land you here. Breathe some fire, kill some mega piranha, and see about this corpse. What is this one? Dropped by me. Okay, that's fine. So that other one over there next to the warden is the one I really want, sadly. Oh, the warden's moved off. Well, kind of moved off. He's still there. All right, well, let's see if we can do this on foot, then. What's your... Are you set to passive still? You are. Good. I don't want you reacting. All right. Let's go head on over there and see if he may just ignore us while we grab that saddle. The wyvern saddles are expensive, man. I want my saddle back. I should probably have left my stuff on... that I just recovered. Don't you think? I probably should have left it on the wyvern. Oh, something's attacking me. Stupid piranha. Wow, they come out of the water pretty far. All right. Yeah, I see that you see me there. Okay, perfect. Perfecto. Let's get out of here. Okay, so I guess our next objective is to find a high-level female. so that we can start breeding some high-level wyverns. I'll look for a really high-level wyvern, whether it's female or male. I prefer female. I do want to start a better breeding program, get higher-level wyverns for big battles. That would be nice. I think one of the problems with Bud and Lou there was that as soon as we started engaging, and this particular warden had flying, henchmen or whatever they're called, acolytes or whatever, and my guy would just fly up to the roof with them and fight them and not try to fight the warden. I couldn't make him fight the warden directly, so that was definitely a problem. So we're going to fly around until we can find some more wyverns. They actually usually were not very hard to find on the center area, the center floating island, so I'm a little surprised that they have not popped up yet, but I'll keep looking. I'm sure they're around. What do we got here? Well, I'm out looking for another female wyvern so I can start reproducing wyverns, and came across this elite dimorphodon. I've come across them before, but this one I knocked down, and it didn't die as soon as get down hit it, so I figured it was a decent level. 335 is not bad. Do I have any golden treats on me? That's a good question. I do not. I do have a sedative narcotic, and I have meat. You know, he's a 335. I don't even need prime meat, honestly. And with a sedative narcotic, he's going to eat up right away. So let's actually do this as kind of an experiment, too. Let's see how much his taming efficiency goes down and how quickly. 99, 98, 164 levels. Oh, look at the baby trike. Hello, baby trike. It looks so tiny compared to this elite dimorphodon. Down to 91% by the time we get it. So that's interesting. This is just going to be a tame first for fun because I don't have one. Can I put this guy? Oh, no, I can ride him, but I was going to say, can I put him on my shoulder? No. How quick is he? He's not that slow. Or she's not that slow. Let's see. At least she can level up. That's good. We might actually take a little bit of time to play with this dimorph. I've never played with an elite dimorph and see what she can do. Let's go ahead and get down to follow me. And I would prefer it if Get Down would follow. Yeah, you can follow me at any distance you want, Get Down. In fact, I'm going to call neutral whistle. Get Down was on passive, which I tend to do with the wyverns and the drakes now. If I'm going to be killing things or knocking things out, I put them on passive so that when I land and eject from them, I don't they don't immediately jump up into the air and go fly off, which they do. They have been known to do. I do that so they won't do that. So I just want to make sure that I put it on neutral. Look at that. Okay. Yeah. Okay, you know, you're going kind of crazy. There we go. Let's take the Darmorph and get down back home and see what we can do with this thing. Okay, first of all, we got to give this guy a name. Let's see. I use up names like Chance and Lucky because I just happen across things, so... instead, we're going to call this guy Snappy. No, Snapper. We'll call him Snapper. Or her, right? Can she be a Snapper? Can Snapper be a she? A Snapper, Snappy, Snap, Snapchat. What color Snapper? I don't know. I just look at her mouth and I think snapping. Like, bah, 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 bah. Just eating, you know? She's got some passive levels. I don't have any XP potions on me. I'm going to leave that meat in there for her to eat. But for now, I think the speed seemed okay. I don't know what the endurance is, but I'm going to give her just melee damage at the moment because we're going to take her out to do a little bit of flying over here. This is the best place, obviously. We like to run around because we sometimes find yellow dodos, golden dodos here too, to fight. So let's see what... wow, he's kind of hard to control. Okay. There we go. Can he attack while on the ground? He cannot. Okay. Got to be flying. That kind of sucks. Okay, are we attacking this elite dodo or not? I don't think we're actually... Oh, boy. The same old dodo problem. They get right up in your grill. Okay, we'll just let you come to us, buddy. There we go. Oh, I got knocked back. Did not notice that until just now. Oh, wow. That one died just standing up. All right, so let's... we can attack elite dodos, but we have to be pointing right at them when we do so. What's his stamina looking like? His stamina's pretty good. Yeah, even sprinting. I don't see much of a stamina loss there. What is over here? Another elite dimorph. I haven't seen that many of them, and all of a sudden, here's another one. What is your level, dude? You're only a 125. You're actually no match for me. Should we have an air battle, guys? Should we do a dogfight? There you go. I think I got its attention. What do you think? Where'd it go? Oh, it's flying away. Okay, it's above us. What did I kill? I didn't kill the Dimorph. Dimorph doesn't even want to come to me. It does not want to come to me. There we go. Now I've got a trike to deal with here. I need to use the test dummy to see exactly what the arc of attack is for this guy. Because I'm not getting a good feel for how he attacks yet. And the dummies are good for that. So let's go ahead and fly out here to our attack dummy. They're good for telling us, you know, how close we need to be to actually hit something. And how, you know, if we can hit something that's behind us and stuff like that. So I'm going to come up here and I'm going to go from here and try to attack. Oh, I'm hitting from here. Wow, that's pretty far away. So it doesn't have to be right up under my mouth. But if it is right up under my mouth, look at that. No attack. It's like right, my head is right in here, no attack. So it doesn't attack from behind? No, you got to be well, it's got to be well in front of you. It's a good thing it has knockbacks. So you have to attack it, well, a little bit further. There we go. Right? Yeah, there we go, yeah. You got to be, it's got to be in front of you. And I guess you depend on your knockback to keep it there. How far down will it attack? So we're kind of above here. Yeah, it'll attack down pretty far too. Well, wait a minute, that was one attack. There we go. I guess if I'm looking at it, if I got it in the center of my screen, that's where he attacks. So wait a minute, will he attack behind if I look behind? Yes, he will. Oh, he's very much like a shark then, like a megalodon. Megalodon attacks that way. Wherever you're pointing the nose, wherever you're pointing your cursor, it attacks. That's pretty cool to know. All right, so melee damage. Give it a little bit of speed, too. Let's get this guy up to like 150. I don't want to go too fast because he's already kind of hard to control. So let's fly around some more and see what we can do. Okay, we're back home after a while. We're not fully there yet. I just want to see what our damage is at. 6020. Okay, not bad. What level are we at now? 540. Cool, cool, cool. Almost to a high level. Wild. But I want to actually go to the underworld now. It was about 6,000 damage there, right? It's always fun to go to the underworld now that we know that it's broken and see... there's the underworld. Its dummy is broken. And see what damage we have. If we have 6,000 up here, we're going to have... After we spawn in, there we go. We're going to have... 36,000! It's not really 36,000, as we know. But I got a little board of the dodos has been pretty much all we had there. Occasional turtle and occasional... what are you? Ooh, I want one of you. What level are you? Oh, you're 535 alpha dodo. I'm coming back for you, man. I'm not going to kill this Bronto because the Bronto will aggro the... Probably, it'll swipe its tail and aggro that dodo. So let's do a little bit more killing, get this guy leveled up, and then maybe come back and get that alpha dodo as well, just for fun. Okay, guys, not quite done in the underworld because it's the big test. My favorite benchmark, the golden dodo. Oh boy, he's hurting me pretty bad. Oh, geez. Wow, I don't have the health for this. I thought I did. Ow. Ow. Let's feed him some of that cooked meat. Whoa, okay. Yeah. I don't have the health for this. I might have to spend the rest of my XP when I get it on health. 10,000 I thought was a fairly nice amount for one of these guys. But we're getting close to 5,000 on melee damage. All right. Continue flying. Okay, I was heading back to the gate and I saw this guy. And for a second I thought he was my alpha, but he's a prime alpha. So we've got our alpha back there at the gate. And then we've got this prime alpha here. So I bumped up my health a little. See if we can kill this guy. I can attack from a height. Oh, at least the dummy told me I could attack from a height. I guess I can't. See if I can kill this. Or maybe I am attacking him. Maybe I'm doing... Oh, I am. There we go. Yeah, I've got a little more health. Let's see if I can actually do some damage to this guy now. Well, that's just the turtle. Oh, no, he's not running. I thought he was running from me. No, he's like, get back over here. Get over here. Trying to get to me. Okay. Oh, got him. Nice. Excellent. What's attacking me, oh, turtle? I probably didn't want to kill that prime. Let's see if I got any of the... Oh, I did. I got the black pearls. That's all I really cared about. I bumped this guy's weight up a bit. I'm saving the prime there because I don't know if I have the right kibble for the alpha. So, guys, I think that's pretty much going to do it for this episode because we're running out of time. I'm bumping up health there. But next episode, I promise, we're going to tame that alpha, and I'm going to do it the right way this time. So, thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.